People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, today I'm going to talk about Horace Chang, James Robertson, and top druggist from Donald Senton side called Norris Dido Nemard. Now, before I go into the video, let me just say, in all my time of gathering information on certain politicians or certain 87 octanes, certain 90 octanes, there is a key circle of people I can call upon to give me reliable and trustworthy information. Every single thing they've ever said to me, I found proof. I've speak to second sources, third sources, look at things like WikiLeaks, and the information always match up. I trust these people's information 100%. But let me tell you something. I have never gotten the reaction about anybody that I get from these men when I mention the name James Robertson. Any politician, no matter how good or bad you think they are, anytime I ask people about those politicians, there's usually a mixture. There's usually some people saying, yeah man, him do bad things, but him do this. Or they might say, yeah man, a good man, man. Or you know, say one time him did do a look one thing, but yeah man, overall is a decent man. That's the kind of things that I'm going to hear. Even Edward Siaga. There are people who will defend Siaga and tell us, boy, Siaga was a good man to the core. But James Robertson, every single person I mentioned his name to gave me the same reaction. It was like I was asking about somebody who took part in some huge strike down there in Libya or something, or down in Iraq. Like I'm asking about somebody who was a part of the Mujahideen or Al-Qaeda. Nobody, and I repeat, nobody, even die-hearted labor rights, have anything good to say about this James Robertson individual. So with that said, let me get into the video. Now, the current Minister of Security, Horace Chang, he was called out by name and exposed on WikiLeaks for having links to a top druggist in Senton by the name of, his nickname was Dido. He was sentenced to 13 years. He was extradited and sentenced to 13 years, but he ended up doing less than that. I think he may not get about 9. I think he's actually down the road now. Dido, if you're listening to this video, jump in the comment section. Open a YouTube account and jump in the comment section. Feel free to defend yourself or back up the allegations. Now, can somebody explain to me how you can have a country and a government where the Minister of National Security has been called out and branded an associate of one of the top druggists in the country? I guess this is why they have that hashtag, Jamaica is not a real place. Surely with a cloud like that hanging over your head, you couldn't get any ministerial jobs, especially Minister of National Security. But somehow Horace Chang has pulled it off. Now Dido might not be as well known as people like Skengdon or people like that, but people from down Senton side know all about him, right? He was one of the long time cash cow, right? Dido made big money. As a matter of fact, the government seized over $200 million worth of asset from him, and that's just what them could find, right? I'm pretty sure he have more stash somewhere, right? Some of the houses that he had look like hotels. They look like palaces fit for a king, right? I think them take about 10 cars as well, right? So this man was living the lifestyle. But James Robertson, he fits into the picture because apparently he's the one that has the real link with Dido. Apparently, his father had to settle problems that restarted by James himself. Right? Apparently, the father had to give up acres of land to settle a dispute between James Robertson and Norris Dillon Emard. Again, may I remind you, this man is a politician in the current government who is now in power in Jamaica. I'm not talking about some old time man who dropped out long time. He's still around, still active, right? But then I thought to myself, considering that James Robertson is a Labour right, let me link my trusty Labour right source when it comes on to shaky politicians. I'm talking about somebody who I'm pretty sure if you cut them, then bleed green. Whole time Labour right. So I made the call. Yo, tell me about James Robertson. Now, for information purposes, this person who I reached out to actually come from Kingston. Let me just leave it at that without getting specific. Person went into great details. They actually told me a very interesting story, and I'm going to pass on that story. Some of you may remember when Dodos' brother, who named Chris Royal, he was Dodos' younger brother. Them go up on the works, right, to carry out a hit. And Chris Royal end up losing life. He was riding on a bike, right? I think it was an off-duty policeman who actually took him down, right? But there was a security guard who was passing by when the policeman had lit down Chris Royal. And by lit down, you know what I mean. I'm not talking with a car. Right, and the security guard, let's just say he helped out the policeman who looked like his royal. My source tell me say when guardman, because obviously Chris Royal come on a presidential click, when guardman them here say police and security played a role in Chris Royal losing his life, some of them set out with a vendetta to get revenge for Chris Royal. But my source make it clear to me that Dodos did not sanction these actions. He made it clear to me that Dodos was actually upset that Chris Royal carried out the work in the first place, because Chris Royal was somewhat of an unruly younger brother. Chris Royal, because he's a part of the family, never really have a tech talk like how a certain man have a tech talk, right? Because he's the Don's brother. He was his own Don in his own little way. Chris Royal had his own little crew. And Chris Royal would carry out work and then end up losing his life. So I tell Mr. Even though Dodos feel it to him hard, it mash him up. He was upset with how Chris Royal deal with the thing. And he did not agree, and he did not sanction any retaliation. But some man from West Kingston, that is, take it upon himself to defend Chris Royal. And in the following days, three policemen and one security guard end up losing their life. But the security company, where the security guard come from, who it was said help mash up Chris Royal, the man who owned that security company was afraid for his life. He believed that, or he heard that guardman them had him on their hit list because they blamed him for what happened to Chris Royal. When the boss of that security company heard that his life could potentially be in danger, he reached out to a politician who he knew had links within presidential clique, and who communicated frequently with the man named from out of West Kingston to get some assurance that he was going to be okay. The politician he reached out to was none other than James Robertson. James Robertson assured him that him don't talk to the other man him already and nothing had happened to the man. Right? Of course, the man did not believe James Robertson, and he was actually trying to get paperwork to actually move his family out of Jamaica, right? Because that's how tense things had gotten. And if anybody remember that time period when Chris Royer lost his life, it was very tense. Any police and any security were marked, especially any security that worked for that company, they were marked men, right? And West Kingston man were dead serious. But again, it was not sanctioned by Dulles. These men were breakaway men who were loyal to Chris Royal and wanted vengeance for him. Now, James Robertson is not just on the local scene for having his name called up in things. James Robertson was actually mentioned as a man who had a hit list out on various people. And he was giving out the names of people who need to be taken out. Of course, James Robertson vehemently denied these allegations and drafting big lawyer, because that's how these men were. They hide behind their big lawyers and they tell you, well, prove it. Right? But somebody who actually ran away from Jamaica and was in America seeking political asylum actually called James Robertson's name in court, saying James Robertson is a proper criminal. Saying that James Robertson is a bad boy disguised as a politician, right? Remember at one point, James Robertson was the deputy leader of the JLP, right? While Bruce Golding was the man in charge. Even the United States government of James Robertson as a very shaky individual. He actually lost his US visa, right? America tell him, say, boy, we don't want you back in the country. We don't want you nowhere near. The furthest that America want James Robertson is Palisades Road. May I remind you, this man is still in politics. When James Robertson lost his US visa, he stepped down from his role as deputy leader. He still maintained his innocence, as usual. But I just want the Jamaican people to know the type of characters that are active in not just our government, but our political field in general. Some of the people who run for campaigns and win campaigns are people who have a long public file out there of serious allegations attached to their name. Now, when it comes on to public service, if the allegation is serious enough, in some countries, that alone make you have to step down. Look at how certain countries deal with them things. If the allegation is serious enough, you have to step down, move aside, and wait till the name clear, then they can come back. But in Jamaica, whether it's allegation, whether you get found guilty, no matter what happens, nothing happens to these politicians. They still hang around until they want to leave. And not only that, but they run elections, they run campaigns, and they win. So in my last video, somebody brought up a question. I don't remember exactly who said it. Please remind me in the comment section. But somebody asked the question, if Jamaica has politicians with these allegations and these sort of criminal acts attached to their name, and they run campaigns and the Jamaican people vote for them again, even with knowing all this information, and vote them back into power, what does that say about the Jamaican people? That's the question I leave you with. If Jamaica as a nation know we have these kind of men in Garden House with these type of allegations, and we have to say allegation because yes, they haven't been found guilty in court, but people in the streets know what's going on. right? Their own constituency tell you about them. Their own constituency tell you that these men are criminals, but then next election vote for them. What does that say about the Jamaican people and our mindset and how seriously we take our country and taking back our country? That is the thought I want to leave you with. People, this is Politics Watch. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. We now have 11 patrons. Listen, we're making slow progress, but making progress nonetheless. I appreciate everyone. Big up on yourself. Please like the video, share the video. Until next time, this is Sir P. Bless.